Voila. Hey, this is Bryan.
And I'm Bryan.
And this is Bryan versus Bryan, episode 3, DC Fandome. Yes, it's Fandome, not fandom. Okay? It's a virtual dome. I don't know why they called it that. It's kind of weird.
It's pretty stupid.
A lot of people are referencing it as fandom, but it's Fandome, okay? It's in a virtual dome.
They made it clear by saying it a lot.
Yeah.
Dome.
The fan square. So anyways, we watched the virtual fan dome, which is pretty much a Comic-Con, right? It's like Comic-Con panels, but Zoom meeting style like we're doing here. And we have some reactions. There's very little shown, a lot of talking, but what was shown we'd like to talk about, and because we love some comic books. We like DC, and DC has not had an easy run of things in the past other than Batman. Batman's always been pretty good. So first thing I think we're going to talk about is Suicide Squad.
Yeah, let's do that.
Okay, so Suicide Squad, what's that? James Gunn is doing it, and it's called Suicide Squad. Again, it's like, hey, remember the other one that wasn't very good? We're doing it over.
Yeah.
It seems like it's just like a kind of a soft reboot because Margot Robbie is still playing Harley Quinn, but everyone else is like recast if they were in the other one. I think the black woman who would like brought them together, she was referenced in the trailer though. She's like, yeah. You hear her voice saying, "Oh, knock 10 years off your sentence." I was like, so you're bringing her back? Is this a sequel or is this like a different thing? I really don't know.
And the leader is the same guy. The leader from the, I don't remember the character's name, but the military guy who gets all the crew together, he's the same guy as well.
The guy, you wouldn't know because you never watched it, but I'm thinking that's the guy who played RoboCop.
Yes, yeah. That guy.
Yeah, pretty white guy.
Mm-hmm.
He was the bomb so of RoboCop. Anyways, and is Idris Elba Will Smith? Did I get that? He's not Deadshot? Oh,
yeah, I think he is. Yeah, I think he is.
I was like, what the fuck was the best part of the first one? I liked Will Smith as Deadshot. I loved him as Deadshot.
He probably wants nothing to do with it. He wants to sit and talk to his wife and talk about some serious shit.
The red table. So, the trailer, if you could call it that, was just, it would show like Margot Robbie, kind of a drawing-esque thing of her, and then say her name. And it went through the characters. And
there's a lot of them.
There's about 20. 20 goddamn characters.
Yeah.
And I bet watch the movie's 45 minutes long, but they're all going to get a really good story arc.
Yeah.
So I don't know how they're going to do it with that many characters. No footage. There was a little thing of behind the scenes where they're filming and stuff. That was way more interesting to me than the trailer. Like after seeing that, I was like, okay, maybe this might be cool. I kind of want to watch it. But from the teaser, the actual teaser where it's like animated, I didn't want to watch it at all. It wasn't
interesting. Like, and it went on forever. Like you're saying, there's like 25 characters. I'm like, how many characters? And I had no idea there was that many characters.
Yeah.
There's like maybe 5 or 6. But it's then like, it kept going and going. John Cena's in it.
Yeah, John Cena.
For some reason.
That was pretty cool. I like John Cena. He's probably going to be really funny in it.
But yeah, I like the BTS stuff they showed. I think Margot Robbie, if I'm not mistaken, kind of summarizes the movie as like a 70s war movie, which I thought was kind of interesting. And a lot of the stuff they showed was kind of in the jungle and people blowing up and explosions. So I'm very interested to see what the actual story is and how they're going to fit 20 characters in a 2-hour movie.
Yeah, I was interested that she said that because in the behind the scenes, there is a jungle part, right? They're showing trees and stuff. And I'm like, wait a fucking minute. Is this now set in the 70s?
Yeah, but I don't know.
I was like, I don't get it. It can't be, because Margot Robbie looks the same exact age as when she was in the other one. But this could be a different universe. This could be just like a complete reboot and has nothing to do with the other one. I don't know.
But I do have faith in James Gunn. He's kind of hit and miss, but I do like the first Guardians of the Galaxy. The second one I didn't really care too much for, but he knows comedy. Yeah. He has got a good sense of pace, and he has good soundtracks, so I think that, I don't know. I think he could do I think he could do it justice. I'm just concerned of how he's going to wrap up
20 characters. Yeah. Polka Dot Man. Mm-hmm. That's one of them.
Didn't know that was... I'm trying to remember
John Cena's character.
He looked awesome though, that goofy helmet and the blaster.
Yeah, and behind the scenes, he's saying he was asking James Gunn, well, who is this character? And he's like, well, it's just like a super douchey Captain America who thinks he's doing the right thing, but he will hesitate to kill anybody. And I was like, oh, that's pretty cool. That's funny. Yeah. John Cena's funny as shit.
Yeah.
He's pretty funny. The shark. The fucking shark looked cool.
Yeah, that's going to be cool.
Fucking Shark Man or whatever the fuck it was. Mm-hmm. But you ever seen that old show or toys, Sewer Sharks?
Is that where the sharks are in, like, jeans?
Yeah, they're like all mouth and shit.
Yeah, I think I remember those.
He looked just like a sewer shark. Mm-hmm. I'll tell you right now that the design of the shark guy from the trailer and the behind the scenes and the trailer looks way cooler than the shark guy in the video game that they announced. With this little shark head. And I was like, dude, you're going to show this fucking shark guy after the awesome sewer sharks?
Right.
It looked way cooler.
Yeah, you want to segue into that?
Yeah, so let's do our takeaways from the Suicide Squad movie. I think it looks interesting. I don't have much faith that they could do all these characters justice. Did you learn anything from, like, Justice League and Spider-Man 3 and everyone who's ever tried to do this with less characters than this has not been able to make a coherent or very good movie. Yeah. So we'll see. Looks like it's just going to be a big action comedy romp. So it looks okay. I want to see it.
Yeah, I want to see it too. I don't have too much to say because, you know, to beat a dead horse, I mean, all they really showed was, here's the new Suicide Squad. It's 25 characters. That's really all we have to say about it. We'll check in later and give you a trailer. I think I'll have a little more hype once I see some footage and a trailer put together. But as of now, I feel like I just got shown, here's a movie with 25 characters. Enjoy. We'll see you later.
Yeah, and the trailer wasn't even, like, really the character. It was a caricature. They were photorealistic, but they were drawn, you could tell, you know. So, anyways, on from that, they also announced that Rocksteady, the creators of the Arkham series, Arkham Asylum, Arkham City, Arkham Knight, are doing Suicide Squad. They announced the full title, which is Suicide Squad Kill the Justice League. And then they had a trailer, which... in my mind, left a lot to be desired. So, the trailer, apparently you find out after the trailer when they're talking with the producer from the game that this is the Arkham story and timeline. So this is Arkham Knight, Arkham City, Arkham Asylum timeline. Now, apparently, Superman is involved and he turned evil. I'm kind of thinking the whole Justice League turned evil. Because they have, like, Will Arnett talking to the characters.
Ugh. After,
yeah, that was terrible.
God damn it.
Talking to the characters, and they're asking, well, did we get to kill all the Justice League? And he's like, yeah, that's the point. And so somehow they turned evil. I don't fucking know about this.
I thought the trailer was fun. I thought there were some fun moments, especially the opening with Harley playing on the thing with the pizza, and like I thought that was kind of fun. And then Outkast starts playing, I kind of check out a little bit. I mean I'm a fan of Rocksteady. I'm a fan of the Batman games. I think it's dope. So I'm kind of stoked to see what they do with multiple characters in this new universe. They're in a Metropolis now, so I'm kind of curious to see how they build that city. But I am really bummed that Superman is a villain, because Superman's one of my favorite superheroes, and every game that he seems to be in, he's just the fucking villain. And I would love to just give me a Superman game. Just quit, because, like...
Yeah, I thought finally they were going to do a...
Suicide Squad is a villain.
Yeah, the big rumor was they were going to be doing a Superman game, Rocksteady, for the longest time.
I love that. Yeah.
That would have been amazing. But apparently no one can do it, because Superman's too powerful, and they can't figure out a game where it would... you know, be any kind of challenge or fun, I guess.
Yeah. So that kind of bummed me out. But I do like the idea of the game hunting down the members of the Justice League and killing them. I think that's kind of a fun new idea.
Yeah.
I'm kind of with you. I'm assuming that they're all evil. I'm assuming something happens that they're all destroying Metropolis for whatever reason. They have to stop them. What else do they say? So it's, you can play a single player, but you can switch between all of the four characters, or you can play co-op, which is kind of fun, I guess.
Yeah. I mean, that part you're talking about where she's doing her hand thing, yeah, that's cool. If it was a movie.
Yeah.
Like that seemed like a really cool thing that should have been in the Suicide Squad movie trailer. Mm-hmm. But for this game, they didn't show shit. They showed them fighting a bunch of generic-ass aliens, which is like probably just going to be tons of amount of filler. Just tons of purple aliens you're fighting. Brainiac wrecked a spaceship or something in Metropolis. I don't know how I'm feeling about it. I'm just not very hyped to play this game at all.
Yeah, it's hard to get...
And I don't care about these characters. I don't care about the Suicide Squad.
It's hard to get excited about a video game when all you have to go on is a CG trailer. You know what I mean? Like,
and 2022 was the date. It's like, God damn, really?
Still a ways out. And that bothers me just in general. Like, when E3 comes out and... somebody gets on stage, here's my new game, and it's just a CG trailer. I'm like, okay, I guess, cool little movie you made, but what does it look like? How does it play? So it's kind of hard to get excited about a CG trailer, but I don't know. I think the idea of them hunting on Justice League is kind of fun and bouncing around different characters. But again, I want to see gameplay. I want to see how the combat works, if it's anything like Arkham. How do the different, is there different play styles with the characters? So
I'm not very excited about it. Characters look kind of lame. Designs look kind of lame when in comparison to the movie that was shown just before it. Like I said, the shark dude looked way more badass in the movie, which should be harder to do than a video game. It's completely just made by hand. So I'm not too excited, and I don't think I'm going to be very much more excited in 2 fucking years. We have to wait. It's like, dude, I'd be way more excited to wait 2 years for Superman or another Batman game.
Yeah.
Anyways, moving on. That segues us into the other video game they announced. Arkham... No, was that what it was called? Arkham Knights.
Gotham Knights or whatever?
Gotham Knights. There it is. So, a completely new timeline than the other Gotham games and done by Warner Brothers, like, Montreal, I think.
Do you know what they've done? I thought that was Rocksteady, but then I was like, oh, wait, no, Rocksteady. Did Montreal do the other Batman game? Remember, because they kind of split the... They made that other Batman Origins. Was that Montreal?
And that's, it might have been. I don't know, so I don't want to comment on it. But probably, I would imagine. Origins was pretty good. It gets a lot of slack, but that one's hella fucking fun, dude. I like that one. It's not, you know, it's more the same. So if you like the other games, you're going to like Origins.
Yeah.
I don't know why it gets so much hate in the Arkham franchise thing. Anyways, this one looked pretty interesting. I'm way more interested in this than the actual Rocksteady game. Because they got Batman dying, which is a pretty interesting story arc. They got Robin, Batgirl, Nightwing, and Red Hood taking over and having to protect the city. So you got 4 characters. You can do co-op at any time. We don't know if it's online only or couch, but you could always have 2 players. And then they showed a 7-minute gameplay trailer, so that one's a lot further along.
Yeah.
And it looked pretty damn cool. It had Mr. Freeze, looked pretty dope.
Yeah, it looked fun.
The whole time I'm just like, chill! Kills a bat! Anyways. And you gotta have some skins, dude. I'm thinking the whole time I'm watching that, because they had all sorts of skins for Arkham Knight. I'm put a Chris O'Donnell skin in there with the bat suit from Batman and Robin, where it looks like Nightwing, but it's red. That suit is dope as shit. Coolest thing to come out of that movie. Put an Arnold Schwarzenegger, Mr. Freeze skin on that bad boy. I was like, dude, I'll play this whole game as Batman and Robin. As Batman and Robin. Got Alicia Silverstone in there. Uh-huh. Dude, that'd be sick.
Don't know if it's gonna happen, but it would be fun. Yeah, the gameplay was looked cool. I liked watching Gotham in snow, and starts off with Batgirl driving her little bat bike through the city and going on to, I don't know, what it was, like a mansion or something. It was all covered in ice.
Yeah. Well, that was Wayne Tower, I think.
Is that Wayne Tower?
I think it was. He took over like Wayne Tower.
And then it ends with the boss fight with Freeze. Yeah, that was cool.
Yeah, it was pretty dope. Bat pod or bat cycle. Mm-hmm. Like everyone had a bat cycle. It's like, we all got one now. The Robin cycle.
Fucking Fast and Furious.
Yeah, it was pretty. It's pretty cool. So, what was next? Wonder Woman?
Yeah, Wonder Woman.
Is that where we are next? Wonder Woman 1984. Gal Gadot. However you pronounce her name. However you pronounce it, it sounds amazing.
Gal Gadot. Anyway,
Gal Gadot. Gal Gadot.
Gal.
Guy get it. Anyways, I thought it looked pretty sweet. I'm not a fan of Wonder Woman very much. I thought the first movie was pretty good. It's a surprise that I liked it as much as I did. This one looks like more of the same. Looks like it will probably be better.
Yeah, this is the first time I've actually seen anything, because I don't watch trailers, which is a whole other discussion. But
until now. Watch...
So I've ignored everything that's come before this, because this movie was supposed to come out in June, I believe. So they've been
promoting. I hadn't seen anything else. Have there been trailers around?
Oh yeah.
Oh.
But so this is the first time that I've seen it, and yeah, it looks fun. I thought the first one was okay. It was a safe movie, and I think it was probably the right movie to release, because at that time, if you remember, like, DC was starting to get a lot of hate, and so they needed kind of a home run, and I think that Wonder Woman kind of came in and made a lot of money, and it got critically acclaimed. So I thought it was okay. It was a generic origin story, but
It was very much Captain America.
Yeah. What I did like, though, about that movie, and I think what elevates it for, you know, if there's anything to elevate, is Gal Gadot and Chris Pine's relationship. I think that they have a lot of chemistry, and I think that it holds that movie together. So I was very happy to see Chris Pine back in this one, because I didn't know, I figured he wasn't going to be back because he died. So I was like, oh, there's a Wonder Woman sequel, and like, if there's no Chris Pine and there's no one for her to bounce off of, like, I'm good. So then when they announced that he was back in it, I'm like, cool, I'm sold. I want to see them together again, bouncing off one another and going on an adventure. They still haven't explained how he's back, which is kind of neat.
And they won't.
And they won't, yeah. So it'll just kind of neat. He's just there for whatever
it'll just
reason.
Be. Yeah, because the other one was like in 1918, right? Does everybody
parachute? Was it World War One? Yeah.
And now it's 1980s. That's a long time.
Yes.
And he looks the same. He looks the same too. And the trailer's like, you look like the day I left. It's like, bitch, so do you. You're not a superhero.
Yeah.
I don't know what's going on. What happened there? Watch. Yeah. He sacrificed himself during the war by going into a glacier, and he was frozen, and then he was thawed. And now he's back in a modern 1980s world. That's never been done before.
Genius.
Never been done. Never
Genius.
Been done. But anyways, their relationship was good. I think Chris Pine's fucking Gadot. I think it's a real relationship.
Mm.
Better watch out. But yeah, it looked pretty good. Kristen Wiig, who...
Yeah, we got to look first like a cheetah.
I've never been a fan of in anything other than SNL, which is... pretty much, I think, just Ghostbusters. Oh, wait, she was good in Bridesmaids.
Bridesmaids, yeah. Bridesmaids.
Kevin Feige has done something good. Mm-hmm. She was hilarious in that. But I don't think she could do a villain. But then, you know, it looked decent. It didn't look like it was just some comedy actress being a villain. It looked like she could legitimately be a good villain.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it looked cool. There's some cool scenery. I know we kind of talked about this earlier before we started recording, but there's that scene where Wonder Woman's like, using her lasso to swing on lightning bolts. I thought that was kind of cool visually.
Yeah, it's like some Spider-Man shit.
Yeah, that was pretty sweet.
Then, I heard they were going to have the invisible plane. No invisible plane in the trailer.
Mm.
I heard that was going to be in this. I don't know how the fuck you're going to do that and not have it be absolutely ridiculous. But because she can pretty much fly. In Batman versus Superman, this motherfucker's... And she's going like fucking blocks. So why do you even need a plane? Anyways.
Yeah, pretty weird. And then there's another, it seems like there's another villain. Is there two villains? Because there's a guy.
Yeah, Pedro Pascal.
Yeah.
The Mando. Oh, cool. The Mandalorian.
You never see his face. You wouldn't even know it was him until you go to IMDb.
Yeah, and what's fucked up is that I heard that most of the time it wasn't him in the suit anyways.
Yeah, that makes sense. They probably just put him in a sound booth and have him read lines.
This is the way.
And have a stuntman, yeah.
Where's the baby? Yeah, he looked like a president or something, some kind of like powerful mogul or
politician,
something.
Yeah,
I don't know what the hell's going on. He has some kind of 80s power suit on, looking like American Psycho, showing off his business card and shit.
So yeah.
That looked pretty good. That was another win. So going from that brings us into my favorite little chunk, my favorite little nug, is the Zack Snyder cut. I've been waiting for this goddamn cut. Justice League, let's get our thoughts out about Justice League, and then we'll bring into the Snyder cut.
Go for it.
No.
I didn't see Justice League in theaters. I didn't really have any desire to see it. And then I remember watching it. It was like on HBO, and I thought it was, not very memorable.
Yeah.
I watched it, and I haven't seen it since. I watched it again last night because I hadn't seen it, and I didn't remember jack shit about it. And I knew we were going to record today, and I knew that we were going to see footage from Zack Snyder. I feel like if I wouldn't have watched it, I would have been like, I don't know what's new, what's not new. So I watched it last night, and it's still fine, and there's cool moments in it, but it is what it is. That's kind of my relationship with that movie. It's I just shrug. Yeah, it's a movie with some cool moments, but other than that, it's not that great.
I thought it was like a 7. It was just not very memorable. The ending was pretty cheesy when it starts turning into a CG Marvel slugfest, but the beginning parts,
the first half is awesome. Like when the team's getting together.
Yeah, they're getting together. The character work, which is probably mostly Zach at that point, is really good. I love that flex. So all of that flex stuff is really good.
Yeah, there's a lot of cool moments. Like I love when he's. I think that Barry Allen steals the show, steals the movie, as far as I'm concerned.
Yeah, he's pretty awesome.
But there's a scene where Bruce shows up at Barry's little hideout and he throws his batarang or whatever.
That's probably one of the coolest,
And he realizes in that moment that he's Bruce, or he's Batman. And then I like the Pet Cemetery line with the Superman coming back. There's a lot of cool moments in there, but...
Yep.
Overall, it's pretty bland.
Yeah. I think a lot of that probably has to do with Zack Snyder leaving and Joss Whedon doing a shit ton of reshoots, and the final film did feel like it was Whedonized. You know, it doesn't seem like a Zack Snyder film. Zack Snyder has a very distinct style, very dark and brooding. I think Warner Brothers thought that wasn't a good thing because of Batman vs. Superman, which I think is an excellent movie. I just watched it the other day. Extended cut Batman vs. Superman is an amazing movie. Stand by it. Love it. It's got a cool story. The last fight's kind of a little lame, but whatever, up till then. It's just hundreds of really enjoyable movie that I can go back to. 3 hours fucking long. Right? And 3 hours for the extended cut, and I can still watch the whole goddamn thing.
Yeah, I never understood the hate
for
that movie. I think it was not deserved. I like that movie a lot, too. I think my only problem is what you said is the ending when Doomsday comes to play. It is what it is. And I fucking hate Jesse Eisenberg as Lex Luthor. I don't know what the hell he's doing in that movie in terms of how he's acting, but he is.
Why would you hate him?
Get out of me. God, I fucking fingers in my eyeballs every time he's on screen. But other than that, I never understood the hate for that movie.
I thought he was all right. I mean, he plays it so fucking weird, but at the same time, he's got these really cool plots. You know, that are like, because he's not strong, he could fucking do anything to Superman or Batman, so he's got to use his mind. But yeah, he plays it like a fucking eccentric. He plays it kind of like the Joker.
Very bizarre.
Joker-esque. But yeah, I think that one's good. Justice League, definitely not as good.
I was surprised when I put it on last Justice League, when I put it on last night, that it was still credited as Snyder. I thought for whatever reason they changed it to Josh, but apparently it was still credited as Snyder.
Yeah, no, it's directed by Zach. It's still credited. They gave Josh a writing credit.
Writing, yeah.
Because he rewrote so much of it. But the parts that he rewrote, he also directed. But I just don't think they wanted to kick Zack Snyder in the ass when he was down and take away his directing credit. So they talked about it. They talked about how they're going to release it. And this motherfucker right here, it's this way, spoiled it for me, claiming it wasn't a spoiler.
It's not a spoiler. Yeah. Hold on. Time out. Stop the bike. Time out. So I say, hold on. So you'll watch a Ghostbusters trailer that shows you footage from the movie that sets the theme and the tone, and that's fine with you. But if someone says, oh, Ghostbusters is an hour and 45 minutes, you're like, you fucking prick. That makes no sense to me.
That's a good point. Here's the difference. There had not been a trailer for Batman or for Justice League, Zack Snyder film, right? So I had no prior reference, and we know nothing about it. There's rumors that it's going to be released episodically. There are rumors that it's going to be this fucking six-hour crazy cut. There are all these rumors. And so I wanted to be alleviated and told this by the man. And then here you are telling me it's 4 one-hour chunks. And I was like, motherfucker, what?
It's good news. If they don't say that in the trailer, you would have had to watch the panel because they do this whole song and dance with Zack Snyder. So you
I did watch the panel because I was very excited for this one.
It was an awful panel, by the way.
Yeah, it wasn't that good of a panel, but you got some good information out of it.
Yeah.
Releasing it 4 chunk hours, I think that's pretty cool because it gives you that huge runtime. They said they're going to have a special version for people that want to watch it as one chunk, which of course I will want to. I don't want to tune in to HBO 1 week and watch hour one and then watch hour two. I don't want to separate it into 4 weeks, or I assume they're going to do it one a week, or hopefully they don't do it like one a month and make us fucking wait 4 months for this whole goddamn thing. Or they could even make us wait the whole damn year, you know, release them throughout the year quarterly.
I don't think they would do that. I hope not.
But I could believe that they would, because from the trailer that they showed, this is going to take a lot of special effects work. Because they showed it and it looked rough. Like, this is like early stuff and it's obviously not very polished from what they showed. But I really like the 1 hour chunks. I don't like that it's episodic. I like that it's going to be 4 hours. I think this movie needs 4 hours. That leads me to believe that they're really going to make it a good movie and flesh out these characters. Like we were saying, 25 characters, you probably need about 9 hours. 4 or 5 characters, Justice League, you probably need about 4.
Yeah.
So what were your thoughts on the 4-hour/4 1-hour episodes?
I think I audibly said, fuck you, when he said that. And then when he said, we're also working on a cut for people who want to watch. And I was like, okay, cool. We're good. We're all good. Because I do not want to watch it episodically. I mean, at the very least, if they were going to do that and not have a cut, I would just wait till all 4 of them were just there, and I would just binge watch 4 of them. It is a weird decision, but I am glad that it's that length, which is kind of weird because most people are like fucking piss their pants when they hear a movie's 3 hours long or 4 hours long, you know, at the very least. But it made me a little more excited because I was worried. Everyone was really excited about the Snyder Cut thing, and I was kind of like, it's Zack Snyder shot so much of that movie, and Joss Whedon had some reshoots, from what I understand. So you're not going to get that much of a different movie. This is me going into the reveal. So I don't know why. I think people are getting this idea that they're going to get a new movie from start to finish. And like my mind says, like, no, you're still going to get the same movie you've already seen. You're just going to get extra padding here and there, kind of like the ultimate cut of Batman v Superman. It's probably going to be half an hour longer. You're going to get a little extra scenes here or there. But it's still going to be a bland movie with just some padding on it. So I don't know why everyone's, you know, jerking off to this Snyder Cut thing. But then when he said it was 4 hours long, it's like, okay, well, maybe there will be a lot more footage than I thought there would be.
Because that's about
he's doing reshoots. So
that's about double, isn't it?
Yeah, Yeah, it's about double. Because, yeah, Justice League's 2 hours on the dot, if I remember right. So, yeah, that made me a little more excited about it in terms of seeing new footage and a newer version of the movie.
I do believe that when he was making this in the beginning, he's sending out the cryptic messages. He showed a film reel, and it said Zack Snyder had like ZS cut JL. And then it said runtime 248 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
So that's where people are thinking, and Warner Brothers made him cut the fuck out of this movie. And I heard they interfered with the editing process extensively. And he claims that he left because of his, I think it was his daughter, right? His daughter's suicide.
Yeah.
But there's a lot of people saying that, oh, he was on his way out before that. They were going to fire him because they just didn't like how it was going. It was way too dark. It was way too long. So I think it's going to be a very different movie, and I'm hoping it's going to be pretty good. I mean, it was okay. So if you elevate it a little bit and put more Zack into it, make it more brutal, I'm guessing it's going to be rated R this time because it's on HBO and it's Zack Snyder. And this is his his vision. I'm pretty sure it's going to be R. I'm pretty sure it's going to be pretty cool. And I'm pretty sure it's going to elevate it to that Batman v Superman status, which I really loved. So that's all I'm hoping for. If you can get to that status of me liking it that much, I'm like, God damn, that's going to be awesome. And it's fucking, 4 years later? And we're getting it? That's amazing. This is a total win for directors and getting your vision. This never happens. This is crazy.
Yeah. I'm hoping that he does some reshoots with Superman and get rid of that mustache bullshit. Really?
Yeah. I think he said he's not going to use any of the mustache footage.
Cool.
That was all Joss. So none of that was because he didn't have the mustache when Zack Snyder was filming.
Yeah.
Until after the movie, he grew it. Then he had to come back for reshoots, and he couldn't shave it because of the contractual obligations. So that's an easy way to tell everything that's Joss, which is most of Superman's arc.
Yes.
So you know right then that – all of Zack Snyder's Superman shit was cut, which he loves Superman. Man of Steel was fucking awesome. I think it's the best Superman movie. So I think that he's going to have a really cool arc for Superman. He said he's going to have a really cool arc and longer arc for Cyborg and the Flash, who I think both really need it.
Yeah.
Especially Cyborg. He's such an afterthought in Justice League. It's like, oh my God, who is this kid? He was going to die in his... Miles Dyson put him in a fucking robot. I was like, dude, this is Dyson?
Yeah. They definitely need some more padding on those characters for sure. I mean, Barry, they at least tried in the original cut with him and his dad in prison and him trying to get him out. But it's very – not much. I mean, it's that scene, and then it's never brought up ever again until the very end. So – and there's a scene where Flash is saving somebody, so that's kind of cool. Like, there's a little more, you know –
yeah,
heroics with him, and
and less of a pussy.
I dig the Superman suit. It's a fucking dope ass black on black.
Well, it's black and silver, right?
Black and silver, yeah.
Yeah, kind of like the Death of Superman suit from the comic books, so that's cool. So
what's with Darkseid? Is he replacing Steppenwolf completely, or is Steppenwolf still in it?
No, but Darkseid is pulling the strings on Steppenwolf, and that's how it always was, but they cut him out. So it made more sense when it was Darkseid, and I guess he was there was going to be some story weave where he was behind the scenes of like Batman versus Superman or something, or helping Lex or something, you know. There was supposed to be this interconnected thing, but the point is, like, Darkseid is supposed to, like, all the post-apocalyptic stuff where it shows the fucked up and Batman with the cape and shit,
mm-hmm.
or like the big duster jacket, and he's fighting aliens and shit. It's like Darkseid has taken over like the world and ruined everything at that point, I think, is what they're saying. And then like Superman has turned evil because Lois gets killed or something. But I think that's all going to be in this movie, because he was saying it was supposed to be, you know, because it was two movies at first, Justice League. It was going to be the first movie, and then the world gets ruined, and then they have to, like, they had to like go back in time with fucking the Flash and change everything again to make it normal. It just sounds like is what's going to happen.
Yeah.
Because if you, I think he said there's going to be some, maybe some time travel, because he was hinting.
Oh, the Flash.
Yeah, he was hinting that the Flash might have something you've never seen him do before. Time travel. I'm excited.
That sets up for Flash's solo, because that's his solo is Flashpoint, which is him traveling through time.
Yeah, we'll get into that after this, because that's a good one to jump into. So I'm excited even more than I was for the Snyder Cut. And it's one of the few things that's coming out soon-ish. Like, most of the shit they're talking about is so far out that it's like, fuck, it's cool. But, man, I mean, what are we going to talk about it for two more years until it happens? But this at least, it's, you know, mostly done filming. It's just some special effects work and then getting the actors back together to probably reshoot some stuff. The trailer looked good. I like the trailer.
It was weird. It was 4:3, but I liked the interesting aesthetic choice.
Yeah. And then the song, I don't know if I was a fan of the song, that song they played over it.
It's fine. That's the mood.
It reminded me of maybe going for more of a Watchmen thing, you know, the fall of innocence kind of thing, which he also did, so it makes sense. But yeah, they showed like the Miles Dyson character who created Cyborg, like getting killed by the box, and it looked like it was going to add a bunch of stuff. It looked pretty sweet. Mm-hmm. I'm excited. Very excited for Snyder Cut. I think that was a big win throughout the whole show. I think that was the best part up to the point of that. We're going to get to what beat it at the end of this video. So that brings us to Flashpoint. They didn't have a trailer or anything, but they did talk about it, and they talked about story arcs. They talked about Affleck is in, and he's going to have a big part. They said it's really the emotional like connection between him and the Flash. That's really the heart of this movie, because, you know, they both lost their mother, and I think the arc is like Batman can't get his mother back, but the Flash can, because he can go back in time, and he's going to try and change everything. So that's going to look really cool. They showed concept art of the new suit, and it had like lights going through it. I don't know if I liked it as much as the Justice League suit. The Justice League suit admittedly was a little too Batman-esque. Like plates and all. It's like, how did you fucking make this? You're just a kid. Like, you're not Batman, and you're not a millionaire, yet you have this badass Iron Man looking suit. But what I found interesting, they show that concept art, and they said it's cool. It's designed, this time it's designed by Bruce Wayne. And in the concept art, who is standing behind him in the shadows? Did you notice this? It was Batman, silhouetted, but boom, yellow, 1989 symbol, and it was Keaton's likeness. I could tell, like those lips and that cowl, I could tell. And there's already been rumors that Michael Keaton is going to be in this movie. So they're thinking that he gets this suit made by Michael Keaton. So I don't know if you caught that in the trailer. I was like, fucking Batman 89!
So unfortunately, I didn't tune in for this one. I knew they weren't in production yet, so maybe they are, but I didn't think they were, so I didn't think they had much to say, so I didn't tune in, but sounds interesting. I'm curious to see if it's Flashpoint, because it's been a long time since I've read it, but from what I remember, Flash goes into a different timeline where Bruce dies, and Bruce's dad becomes Batman. So I'm wondering where, if they're actually doing Flashpoint or like a different iteration of it. Because if they are doing Flashpoint, then who the fuck is Affleck is Batman and Michael Keaton is Batman? Unless they're doing their own version of Flashpoint. Or maybe I'm just remembering it wrong. But I'm pretty sure that when Barry goes to that different timeline, it's not Bruce, it's his dad.
Yeah, you're right. But I don't think they're doing Flashpoint. I think they're using that as a reference. They're going to do time travel. They're going to do the multiverse. Superman is because you watch the panel. It's pretty interesting. Of course, and that guy, Ezra Alba, or again, what the hell's his name?
Ezra Miller.
He's pretty interesting. He's funny to just listen to talk. He's talking about it. You can tell he loves the Flash. He loves the character, so that's pretty cool. even though he might be a fucking stupid jackass in real life. Punching some dude. Barry, because he's got this, I think it was a girl too, wasn't it? Time.
Anyways, oh, hilarious.
Stop! Don't ask me for a picture!
Yeah.
Should have just ran away like Naruto. Fuck you! Anyways. So he's talking about the multiverse, and he's like, yeah, it's so cool because there's been all these iterations of Batman, and then they show clips of 89, they show clips of Val Kilmer, they show clips of George Clooney, they show Ben Affleck. And if they really treat this like a multiverse movie, and they're showing clips from the TV show, and he's like, there's so much of these characters and the director saying this stuff too, that aren't connected. They aren't. They stand by themselves, and they show Joker. You know, the Joker movie with Joaquin Phoenix. So if they could really make this into like a Spider-Verse movie, like, dude, they bring in like George Clooney for a fucking little cameo spot. They bring in Val Kilmer for a good. And
his immense power is really what's exciting about superheroes to me.
Michael Keaton.
He looks like hammer shit.
Like, dude, he's got his fucking trigger
faster than the human being.
Robin.
Beware.
Dude, he looks like hell.
Brings something different to the character.
God bless that girl.
God bless that
girl. Rest in peace. But if they could bring all this shit into this movie, it could be like probably one of the coolest superhero movies ever made, dude. If they really take a Spider-Verse approach to it, but real life, like live action, this thing could be fucking a killer at the box office, dude.
Yeah, I mean, the closest I can think of is Avengers. I mean, I remember just seeing all those characters in one movie was, like, insane. And the fact that it worked.
Yeah.
I think so, like, if they could do that with Flash, that would be awesome.
If they could do that with this, I think it'd be even better. Because these are characters we've already known and loved and established, right? People love fucking Michael Keaton's Batman. People love all these different DC characters in the past.
We even have now multiple iterations of the
Phoenix
same
to bring
story.
In fucking Jared Leto, stupid ass Joker, just to
sound
make fun
like
of
a
him.
Cool guy.
I could, you know they would. Just to be, who's this guy? He runs by him. I'm deranged. This is the stupidest shit I've ever seen.
Yeah, bro.
Yeah, Leto. Oh, anyways, we're not gonna get started on that.
Yeah.
But yeah, I thought that panel was
possible now.
Probably the most exciting for not having anything. They had a piece of concept art.
Don't do this to me. I don't know about
that. And that was about it. And so if you're getting me excited off of fucking concept art and an actor talking about the project because he's got so much passion, I'm in. I think it's going to be really cool. And it's the movie that got fucking that like that.
I can't wait for all of us to be able to sit down in a theater and enjoy these movies.
So that was that. And then last. The cherry on top,
and
the coupe du jour,
snacks.
Is what they call a little film.
So obviously,
the
I
Batman.
Don't spoil.
Who's this guy? Is it Matt Reeves? Is that the director's name? Mm-hmm. What the fuck has he done?
Oh man, Matt Reeves is the shit. So he starts with Cloverfield, which I think I remember you weren't a huge fan of.
I liked Cloverfield. It was okay.
Out of all the found footage movies, I think it's one of the better ones.
That's interesting. That's
that's how he starts. And then he makes a movie called Let Me In, which is a vampire remake of a Swedish movie. Awesome movie.
I've seen that one.
Then he makes a trilogy of Dawn of the Planet of the Apes and War of the Planet of the Apes.
Oh, yeah, yeah. But
if anybody out there who hasn't seen that trilogy, you need to fucking watch it ASAP, because that trilogy is very underrated. That trilogy is awesome.
I think they're good, but I'm just not a big fan of it. It's just that fucking who's that guy, the motion capture guy that plays the ape?
Andy Serkis.
Yeah, Serkis. Is just fucking too weird. This ape is too realistic, dude. It's just like
we're really watching apes talk.
This ape has been through too much.
Yeah.
I was around when the humans. Anyways, they're pretty good.
Those
but they're just
awesome.
They're just not my thing.
I think they're underrated. I think they're great. And then, which leads him to the Batman. So in my mind, he hasn't made a bad movie as far as I'm concerned. So that makes me excited.
Wait a minute. Did he make the Marky Mark Planet of the Apes?
No. That was Tim Burton.
I actually like that one. I think I'm kind of the minority. I like that fucking movie.
The fun, Have a good one.
I like that movie. Yeah, I'm from Boston, and there's a bunch of fucking apes. Who are these fucking apes around here? I'm a fucking astronaut over here with a fucking ape. I should be beating you, little ape. You're going to be beating me, little ape? I'm going to fuck this sexy ape. The sexy ape that gets him out of the car. That movie's awesome.
That movie's so bad.
It's got Michael Clark Duncan ape. That's the most racist shit I've ever seen. Like he needed a costume. How racist is this? You got Michael Clark Duncan playing a big-ass ape. Oh, my God. Couldn't do that now, my friend.
I forgot that movie existed until just now. Oh, shit.
Oh, I loved it as a kid.
The Batman.
This was your thing. You were super excited for this. I was excited for Snyder Cut, so you go ahead and bring us into the Batman.
Dude, the Batman stole it. Stole the whole fucking thing.
Yeah.
As far as I'm concerned. Holy shit. That movie looks rad. And I think... we haven't really talked about the panels. I mean, we kind of talked about it a little bit, but I think out of all the panels I watched, I think that one was the most interesting. It was just Matt Reeves. I mean, I think it was a little too long. I think it probably could have cut it down by like 10 minutes, but it was fun to see him so passionate about the project and explaining what the project is. A lot of stuff I didn't know. I didn't know that. So this is going to take place on year two of Bruce as Batman in Gotham, and Gotham doesn't really know what to make of the Batman yet.
Did they say that? I thought they said it was going to be like he's a couple years in. They said year two, though?
Year two. Okay. The bat suit is made specifically so it looks like that Bruce actually made it himself and not, you know, going to Lucius Fox or something. And it's a detective story where he's solving a crime and he's finding corruption.
The Riddler.
Yes.
The Riddler was a big part. I didn't know who the fuck that was. It was like some dude with tape on his face and he's got fucking goggles. I was like, who the fuck is that? I thought the Penguin was the bad guy in this. And then but the way he was talking, I was like, okay, sound pretty Riddler-esque. And then at the end, Reeves was like, oh, Riddler, he's doing Riddler in a way that's never been done. So I was like, okay, let's play a game. Riddler.
Just me and you.
But fuck, dude. Fuck, this movie looks good. This movie looks so good. I can't wait. This probably like, it reached very high on my I want that movie, I'll kill somebody to watch this movie right now.
It looked like it was going back to Christopher Nolan days. Very dark and gritty, cool Batman. That guy from Westworld is playing Commissioner Gordon. Looks pretty sweet. I don't know if he's Commissioner yet. He might be like Captain Gordon, you know, how they usually do. They don't start him as Commissioner in these movies, usually.
Yeah, he said that, I think Matt Reeves said that all these characters are, like, in the beginning stages of what we know them as. So I think, like, Catwoman is just a woman in a you know. So I think that, I'm assuming that he's just the captain. He's not.
Commissioner Gordon is a traffic cop. He's writing tickets. So, the trailer was fucking gritty. It looked dope as shit.
Pattinson looked great. I mean,
suit looks pretty cool.
That one guy that was fucking red.
Oh, yeah, the part when he just fucking start beating him. Like that kid starts crying, watching him. Oh, so it's got to be, there's Joker in it. Joker is in it. I mean, if he's not in it, he's around. Because everybody's got the fucking smiling face.
The white
fangs. Yeah. So I hear that Joker's not actually going to be in it. I heard that he's kind of like a Voldemort character. Everybody knows of him. Everybody knows of him and is afraid of him, but nobody has really like ever seen him type of thing. So that's kind of cool. They didn't show the Penguin at all, which was like the main villain, I thought, Colin Farrell. I'm still curious how the fuck Colin Farrell is going to play the Penguin.
Yeah.
Unless they do a very, you know, Oswald Cobblepot version. Like, I don't know, the Telltale Games Batman, that Penguin seems like is what they're going for, where it's like not disfigured at all, really. He's just kind of fucking a sly businessman.
Yeah, I'm assuming that's what they're going to go for, too. I mean, even, I think he even says in the panel that, like, I mean, again, these characters are not what we know them as yet. They're kind of in the early stages of becoming who they are. But he was saying that even Oz himself doesn't like the nickname Penguin. Or, like, I'm assuming in the movie they start calling Penguin, and he's probably going to flip the fuck out. But, yeah, I'm interested to see Colin Farrell. But, yeah, they didn't show him. The whole thing was I fucking wanted to do a handstand and jump off a balcony in excitement. But The only thing I didn't like, I still don't like the Batmobile. It just looks like a souped-up car. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like,
I'm not too enthused with the Batmobile. I like it more than the Batfleck Batmobile. I'm not a big fan of the Batfleck Batmobile. I think they tried to go sports car and tumbler, and it just didn't hit either for me. Tumbler was amazing. I think the one in Dark Knight or Arkham Knight, the game, is pretty sweet.
Fucking tank.
Yeah. This one's just a car, which makes more sense. I mean,
I guess it makes sense to you too. Yeah.
He's not gonna have a fucking tank or some shit. He's not gonna be able to build a fucking sports car from the ground up. People can't just build cars. You have to be so specialized in that kind of shit to do that. So it makes more sense that he would take an already made car and then modify it. So we'll see. I bet there's still more to show with that. That's gonna make us like it more. Mm-hmm. I'm sure. Because everything else looks pretty sweet.
Yeah. And I will say, I think this is it for me with the Batman. I don't want to see anything else. I don't want to see a fucking screenshot. I don't want to see another trailer. I'm done. I'm already sold. You already have my money. You have my excitement. Like, just, I'm going to wait for 2 years or whenever this thing's released, and I'm going to walk into that theater.
Yeah.
Because that was enough for me. That was awesome.
Yeah, it looked awesome. What else was in that trailer? It's kind of... In the panel, it was kind of interesting. They had Robert Pattinson first talk, and that guy's a fucking weirdo, dude.
He did not give a shit, and I loved it. He was like, I'm Batman. Can't really say a whole lot. I'm going to let Matt Reeves talk about it.
I hope you like the movie.
Yeah.
It's a character piece.
He did not give two shits about
it. And he's like, Matt Reeves is over here.
Over there.
Or over here. And he wasn't there at all. He was the only one on the screen, but I'm excited. You know, we stopped filming because of the pandemic, so we will finish the film at some point. It's like,
yeah,
he was very nonchalant. Like, he didn't give a fuck, dude. He's just too cool.
One of the things, you're an actor, and some of your agents probably like, hey, you gotta do this thing. They're doing a DC fandom. You have to talk on camera. He's probably like, fuck, all right, here I am. I'll do your little song and dance. Yeah. But yeah, I like that he just had a whatever attitude about it.
So, yeah, agree that stole the show. The Batman looks pretty sweet. I'm still disappointed that we never got Ben Affleck's The Batman. Mm-hmm. But we got this, at least. This looks pretty sweet. It just kind of sucks. It's not interconnected, you know? I wish these stories were more connected, like Joker and Batman's and all these things, but...
Yeah, it was kind of a bummer about the Joker movie. That movie's great, but it's not going to fit in. It's kind of its own standalone thing. And I think that when that Joker came out, a lot of people had the same issues with it in terms of like, man, it kind of sucks it's not. But I heard someone say that's kind of the direction that Warner Brothers kind of likes. They like to do the standalone type of movies, mm-hmm. which kind of makes sense now that they're doing this Batman.
Yeah, but then they're also doing the DCEU, so, yeah, well, who knows? Hey, you never know. We could get them in there with some Flashpoint-style stories, maybe.
Mm-hmm.
Every Flash movie is just a movie that they fucking amalgamize everything. That's what the Flash movies are for.
Uh-huh.
So, overall, I think it was a pretty fucking awesome show. A lot of cool stuff shown.
A lot of cool stuff shown. The show itself was crazy. Yeah. I think it was 8 hours long. They could have easily shortened it down to like two.
And it's only half. Three. It's only half.
Yeah.
There's going to be another day of 8 hours.
Oh, my God.
You know,
why?
It's 12 hours. It cut it down. It was going to be 24 hours straight stream. And you know what sucked? I was pissed. I kept trying to find the panels online because I missed them live. And you go on the website and it's just the live. They don't let you watch the old shit.
Mm-hmm.
And they didn't put them up on YouTube, very little. Like, I couldn't find the Batman panel. All I could find was people reacting to it. I couldn't find the actual panel.
That was the most frustrating thing. Like, even just trying to find where I needed to be to watch it, I had to, like, Google it, and then I went to a website, and then I'm like, why aren't you just putting this stream on YouTube, on your DC page? Exactly. Everyone's on YouTube. Everyone watches YouTube. Quit channeling people to your stupid-ass website that no one wants to be on anyway. Just put it up on YouTube.
Which has nothing on the website but that. So what was the point? It's not like you were monetizing it. There wasn't any ads or anything. You could have put ads on your fucking YouTube page and got a billion fucking views of this.
Well, I had to sign up. So maybe that's what they're trying to get.
You had to sign up?
Yeah, I had to type in my email and a fucking
message. I didn't sign up. I think you got scammed, bro.
Damn it, here come the newsletters.
Yeah, I just went to the website and it was playing.
Shit. Yeah, they made me sign up. That's bullshit.
Uh-oh. Put your social security in here, credit card.
Yeah. Is your blood.
Yep. All right, so any final words? I'm excited for Flash, even though nothing was shown. I'm excited for Wonder Woman. It looks better than I thought it would. Mm-hmm. Zack Snyder cut. I think it's going to be better than I thought it could be with this new runtime. Like, damn, you're going to add a lot to this movie. I didn't think it was going to be that extensive. And then super excited. I think we both are about The Batman.
Yeah.
I wasn't that enthused about it. I think it looked good. Suit looked good. Things I heard looked good. But fuck, the trailer was good. Mm-hmm. Trailer was real good. It was definitely a Dark Knight-esque trailer. Like, it brought me right back to watching Batman Begins trailer. I'm like, oh shit, they're going dark and cool with this.
Yeah, it's the first Batman movie I've been excited about, like this excited about, since I think the Dark Knight trailer with the Joker, Heath Ledger.
Definitely.
So yeah, I echo everything you said. I think Wonder Woman looks cool. I want to check it out. I'm not like doing jumping jacks for it, but I do want to see it. The Flash sounds cool. I'll probably go back and watch that panel. Sounds like you like some stuff about it, so I'll probably go back and watch it. Black Adam didn't really have much to say other than The Rock's doing a movie called Black Adam.
This is Drew the Rock.
Yeah.
It's like Moana or some shit.
Yeah. I didn't watch Aquaman, so I didn't. I know there's a sequel. It'll come when it comes. Yeah, I'm more excited about the Snyder Cut now than I was going in. So that's good. And then, yeah, the Batman stole the show for me.
For sure. Well, I guess that's it then, huh?
Yeah.
All right, guys. Tell us what you thought about the Fandom. Not Fandom, Fandom. That was our thoughts. This is Bryan versus Bryan. Please like and subscribe. And until next time, I guess the fire rises.
Brother.
Later, Tater.
Bye.
Peace.